हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू योर चैनल आर्ट ऑफ मैथमेटिका। सो गाइस, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंप्लीट दिस वर्कशीट, दैट वर्कशीट 4। दिस लेक्चर इज ऑल अबाउट ट्रायंगल एंड इट्स प्रॉपर्टी, वर्कशीट 4। सो दिस इज द लास्ट पार्ट, पार्ट 4 यू कैन सी। इफ यू हैव नॉट सीन स्टिल इफ यू हैव नॉट सीन द प्रीवियस वन, go to my playlist, go and check over there. And one more thing, you can go to the description also, you will get all the links of this chapter video. Okay, one more thing, above I button, yeah, you can see that, go and click over there, you will get the videos of this chapter. So let's get started. So question number 8, and I have told you, remember, that in this part, means lecture, I am going to complete question number 8 and 9 both. Why? Because both are similar type of sum. So let's do. If the side of a triangle are 3 meter, 4 meter, and 6 meter long, determine whether the triangle is a right triangle. Let's check it. By doing a chart, it is better to do. So let's do it. Before that, let me try. And if whenever you are going to try, check it now. What to do? Just it is a right angle triangle or not, they have to asked to do. So sides are 3, 4, 6. 3, 4, 6. Okay, now. So do you remember that left hand side, and then by it is an it is a right angle triangle or not, that which property says you? That Pythagoras theorem? No, the Pythagoras theorem says that length of other two sides square, sum of the length of the other two sides square, is equals to the third side, means hypotenuse. So in this triangle, see, one thing you have to make it clear, one thing you have to keep in your mind, just make these things clear, that the longest side, or these three are the length of the sides. Okay, here the longest side is the hypotenuse, because in a right angle triangle, that longest side will be the hypotenuse. You all know that hypotenuse implies longest side in this triangle. So here 6 is the longest one among these all three. So I am going to take this as a hypotenuse, that's why. So suppose 3, 6, and 9. Which one I am going to take as a hypotenuse? 9, because 9 is the longest one. Got it? Is there any doubt? I think you shouldn't have any doubt. So Pythagoras theorem said that these two, no, A, B, C. If I take the side of the length, length of the side, so that in we know what? Nothing. We know that sum of the length of the other two square, means in right triangle, ABC, AB square plus BC square equals to AC square. It is, agar this, so if this one is verified, no, we can say, yeah, this is the triplets of a right angle triangle. So there are two equal, this is left side, this is right side, so I can verify now. So that means, think of it, it is a equal sign, its left hand side is this, and this one is the right hand side. Think of it. So I am going to verify this. Do you remember that in chapter 2 you have done the verification, and other chapter also, many of the chapters you have done the verification, like exponent and power, there also you have done. So do it. So LHS, their RHS, if they are equal, we have to say this is the triplets of a triangle, right angle triangle. So AB means what? 3 square plus BC means 4 square. You can see AB plus BC square, AB square means 3 square, AB 3 and BC 4. So this equals to, now 3 square 9, 4 square 16, 25. Now RHS is what? AC square, that is 6 square equals to 36. See, 25 does not equals to 36, they are not same. So what to say, what they have asked? That whether the triangle is a right angle triangle. So Therefore, no, it is not a right triangle. It is not a right triangle. So, understood now how to do these sums? So, similar method I am going to follow. This is definitely question number 8. That similar method I am going to follow this question number 9 also. That they have asked, verify whether the following triplets are Pythagorean or not. Pythagorean triplets meaning what? It is a right angle triangle. What I have done here? That I have checked their Pythagorean triplets or not. If yes, then it is a right angle triangle. If no, then it is not a right angle triangle. Clear na? So these 8 number and 9 number are similar type of sum. Clear? So no issue. I am going to solve these also, but I am not going to explain vastly. There I have explained all the thing, the process, everything I have explained. Just here I am going to show you that it is true or false. Okay? So as I have told you, I am going to calculate and show you that it is a Pythagorean triplet or not. That whether the following triplets are Pythagorean or not. So, you know the longest one. How to find out which one is the hypotenuse? The longest one. So, among these three, which one is the longest one? 10. So, 10 should be at the right side, this at the left. So, we know that a square plus b square equals to c square. In your book it is given, if it is a triangle, this is a, this is b. Just a minute. This is a, this is b, and that one is c. Remember na? So this way I am going to write also, or directly you can do it, perpendicular square plus a base square equals to hypotenuse square. Okay, so that left hand side I have to verify, that is what, 8 square plus 9 square, and the right hand side 10 square. So equals to 8 square is 64, 9 square is 81, so 5 nothing carried, 6 or 14, what is power, 145, and this is 100. So are they equal? So they are not equal. So we can write, therefore 145 not equals to 100. So it is not a Pythagorean triplet. Okay, because they are not same. Now this one, similar process I have to follow, LHS and RHS. So tell me, see simply na, the biggest one should be the right hand side. Just calculate this in your mind. Just biggest one should be in the right side. 5 square, 7 square. This is 25. 7 square is 49. 5 and then 4, 1 carried. That is 3, 7, 74. Again, not possible. This is 144. Actually, I know the square of all these. If you don't know, you have to calculate. You don't have any other option. So 74 again not equals to 144. So what can I say? Therefore, again, it is not a Pythagorean triplet. Okay. Now question number 3. I shouldn't do all the sum. Chalo, kar dete hai, koi baat nahi. So 3, 4 and 5. So again, biggest one is what? Greater one, 5. So this should be in the right hand side, and the left hand side, the remaining two, 3 square, 4 square. Very easy and very same, means similar formula you have to do. 9, 16 gives 25. Good. The 5 square, 25. At last we have got one triplet that are equal. So therefore LHS equals to RHS. So therefore yes, it is a Pythagorean triplet. Let's see this one. It is also true. RHS. Actually, try to do it now in your own. That pause the video and do it, and then check it. It is right or not. So let's do LHS. That 5 square plus 12 square. Why? Because 13 is the greater one than among 3, and here 15 is the greater one. So same method, 13 square 169, that's good. That is 25, this is 144. If you add them, you will get again 169. So yes, LHS equals to RHS. So we can say that yes, it is a Pythagorean triplet. The last one, same, LHS equals to 9 square plus 12 square. I am going to do down, 9 square 81, 144, 5, 2, 1 carat. Now this is 2 to 5. So now RHS, that is 15 square. You all know 15 square is also 2 to 5. So LHS equals to RHS, that means yes, it is also a Pythagorean triplet. I am not going to write, you will do it. So that's it for today. This worksheet also completed. Chalo, let me tell you one thing. Iske baad ka jo aa raha hai na, bahut hi chhota chhota worksheet hai, ye mujhe pata hai. Bas ye 5 minute mein ye khatam kar denge, lekin hum nahi karne wale. हमें ना एक बात कहना तुम लोगों को, जो अभी अंत तक आए हैं उन लोगों के लिए, मैं हमेशा ये चाहता तो वीडियो के बिगिनिंग में कह सकता हूँ, लेकिन जो लोग अंत तक वीडियो को देखते हो उन लोगों को सीखने का चाहत है, ये मुझे पता है, इसलिए उन लोगों के लिए मैं कह रहा हूँ कि देखो, अगर तुम्हें लगता है कि जो वर्कशीट 5, 6, 7 जो है बहुत ईजी है, बस छोटा छोटा फिल इन द ब्लैंक से, ट्रू फॉल्स है, ऐसा नहीं बेटा, इसमें जो है ना कंसेप्ट बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. सो इन दिस आफ्टर मीन्स आफ्टर वर्कशीट 4, दिस इज तो कंप्लीटेड. आफ्टर दिस वर्कशीट देर आर थ्री और फोर वर्कशीट्स लेफ्ट, दे आर ऑल अबाउट कंसेप्ट. सो मैं ना इसके बाद जो आएगा मीडियन आएगा, तो मीडियन क्या है, उसका डेफिनेशन कैसे लिखोगे, कैसे याद रखोगे, उसके नेम से तुम्हें रिलेट कर दूंगा कि इसको भूलोगे नहीं. फिर कन्फ्यूजन क्या होता है पता है ना, तुम लोग जो अभी पढ़ चुके उन लोगों को ये पता है, मीडियन, ऑर्थो सेंटर, सर्कम सेंटर, इन सेंटर, ये यहाँ पे बहुत सारे कन्फ्यूजन क्रिएट हो जाता है. बच्चे किसी तरह से मीडियन को अगर याद भी रख लेते हैं, लेकिन बाकी जो है भूल जाते हैं. तो डोंट वरी, आई एम हियर. सो वेट कर लो थोड़ा और, मतलब अभी बनाते जाऊँगा, ठीक है ना. अगर कुछ मेरा हेल्थ का ऐसा मतलब कुछ ऐसा नहीं हुआ, मतलब मेरा एक्चुअली इतना क्या है, स्कूल में क्लास चल रहा है, यहाँ पे पढ़ा रहा हूँ तुम लोगों को, ट्यूशन, मतलब हर जगह पे ये बग 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 करते हुए बात, मतलब हमेशा मैं मुझे कुछ ना कुछ कहता हूँ, मतलब पढ़ाता हूँ हमेशा ना, तो इसलिए मेरा जो वोकल कॉर्ड है उसका रेस्ट नहीं मिल रहा था, तो इसलिए वहाँ से एक प्रॉब्लम हो चुका है. अभी भी हो रहा है, थोड़ा बहुत हो रहा है प्रॉब्लम, यहाँ पे पेन हो रहा है बात करने में. कोई बात नहीं तुम लोगों के लिए, ठीक है. सो I hope guys you all like this one, and अंत तक देखना वीडियो को, बहुत मेहनत होता है. तो जो लोग अभी अंत तक हो, तहे दिल से उन लोगों को शुक्रिया. सो तब तक के लिए all of you take care. मेरे नेक्स्ट वीडियो में मैं वर्कशीट 5 लेके आऊँगा. सो गुड बाय.